Hi, my name is Julia, and I'm going to show you how to use different types of breakpoints when debugging C++ programs in VS Code, specifically focusing on data breakpoints. In the demo today, I'll be using a simple Fibonacci program as an example that prints the first 15 terms of a Fibonacci sequence. Breakpoints are one of the most critical elements of your developer toolbox. You use breakpoints anytime you want the debugger to pause execution. You might want the debugger to pause every time a certain line number is reached in a source file. For example, in this Fibonacci program, if I want the debugger to pause every time we hit line 26, which is where we're calculating what the next term in the Fibonacci sequence should be, I can do that by just clicking on the left margin on line 26. Or maybe you want the debugger to pause on line 26, but not every time it hits line 26. Maybe you want the debugger to pause only when we're calculating the fifth term of the Fibonacci sequence. You can do that by setting a conditional breakpoint. Right-click on the red dot and then select Edit Breakpoint. And then we can write our condition, which would be when I, which is our counter in our for loop, equals 5. Now, if we start the debugger, we should break on line 26, but only when our local variable I is equal to 5. So our debugger launched, and sure enough, it stopped on line 26, which as indicated by the yellow hollow marker. And in the terminal, we can see that it did print the first four terms of the Fibonacci sequence, so we're on the fifth. And we can verify that our breakpoint condition worked by checking out the value of I in the local variables section of the debug pane. And sure enough, I is equal to 5. So I just talked about two different types of breakpoints. The first is just breaking whenever a line number is reached in a source file. The second is setting a conditional breakpoint. And there's a third type of breakpoint that you can set, which is whenever the data stored at a specific memory address changes. You can have the debugger pause on that condition. And that's called a data breakpoint. And just to clarify, data breakpoints are available in VS Code only if you are debugging using GDB. You can set data breakpoints in VS Code in the variables section of the debug pane. For example, maybe I want this program to break execution whenever the value of the next term local variable changes. I'm going to right-click on next term in the debug pane and then select break on value change. Now, in the breakpoint section at the bottom of the debug pane, I can see my data breakpoint listed here, and it's labeled when next term changes, and then I can see the size as well, which is 4 bytes because it is an int. To test that this works, I'm going to disable the breakpoint that I had previously set. So now the only breakpoint I have set for this program is a data breakpoint for the next term local variable. If I continue running the program, we should break whenever the next term variable changes value. And it just changed from 2 to 3, so we broke. Let's try again. It changed from 3 to 5, so the debugger paused again. And we can keep going, and so on and so forth. Now, data breakpoints cause the debugger to pause only when the data stored at that memory address changes. It's not when that data is read. So let's say I had decided to set a data breakpoint instead on the local variable n, which does not change throughout the course of this program. It's read multiple times throughout the program, but it doesn't change. So if I set a data breakpoint, and then let's disable the data breakpoint on the next term variable, the program should just run through. We should just finish printing all 15 terms of the Fibonacci sequence, and the debugger should not pause execution. Let's check it out. And sure enough, the program ran through, the debugger did not break because the value of local variable n never changed. There are limitations with data breakpoints. Let's say I had instead set a data breakpoint on my string MSG local variable, which is just a string that says printing Fibonacci sequence. I'm going to start the debugger so that we can set that data breakpoint and see if we run into any issues. Okay, so the debugger has launched and we can step through it. And now I'm going to set a data breakpoint on this string local variable, break on value change. Now, in the debug console, I see this error message. It says, unable to set data breakpoint, value does not fall within the expected range parameter size. What does that mean? Well, the string type is 32 bytes, and there's a limitation on the size that we can set data breakpoints on. This limitation comes from the fact that the platform that you run your program on has a limited number of hardware data breakpoints that it can use. You can check out the Microsoft documentation to learn about how many registers are available to use for each architecture. One sneaky tip that I want to end on for debugging with GDB in VS Code is that in the debug console, you can interact with GDB using command line syntax the same way you would when running GDB from the terminal, as long as you use a backtick before typing the commands. So for example, if I wanted to learn about all of the breakpoints that I have set, I can type the backtick and then write info breakpoints as you would when running GDB from the terminal, and then I can see the output from GDB displayed in the debug console. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you learned more about using different kinds of breakpoints in Visual Studio Code for C++. Enjoy the rest of the Pure Virtual C++ conference. Thanks.